Welcome to my channel. So in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss black box testing. We have two types of testing. One is black box testing and one is white box testing. But in this video, we are going to discuss about the black box testing. Okay, so just coding the program is not enough. We also need to test the program. The more error-free your program will be, the quality of the software is going to be good. Okay, we have to make our program error-free. So the question is, you want to test your program, but the question is how to test the program. So how black box testing is going to work? We have a written code for our program. Several lines of code is there. But if you look at the statements or the instruction of your program, if you look at each and every instruction of your program to check if there is any error in the program or not, then it is going to be very much time consuming. We want to test our program as fast as possible. Okay, so what we do in black box testing, instead of checking the each and every statement of the program, we just check the functionality. Or the outer behavior of the program. Means if you are giving some input, then is your program giving the expected output? Okay. What we try to check, if you are giving some input, then whether it is giving right output or not. Okay, we don't indulge ourselves in the coding. We don't check each and every statement of the code. We just check the behavior of the program. We just check if we are giving some input to the program, then whether it is giving the correct output or not. Okay, we check the behavior of the program. Okay, so that is actually the black box testing. Let me give you one example. We have two ways of black box testing. One is equivalence class partitioning and one we have is boundary value analysis. So what happens? Okay, I have made this software. word. Okay, let me give you one example so that you can understand better. Let's suppose while you are opening your Gmail, firstly you are signing up. Okay, while signing up, you are writing this email ID and you are giving this password. Okay, while signing up. Okay, but when you are logging in after signing up, these values are stored in your database. But when you have to log in, what you are writing a@gmail.com. But in the password, you write value 12345. Still, you are able to enter into the Gmail, even if you are writing the wrong password. Okay, so we have to avoid such kind of errors. What was the original password? 1234. But you have done your coding in such a way that even if you are writing 12345 password, still you are going to enter into the Gmail. So this is a completely wrong. This is not acceptable. You can't commit this kind of error. Then what is the meaning of making the software if you are not able to handle the errors? Okay, so similarly, what I am trying to say, I have a machine which is going to compute the square root from 0 to 5000. Okay, so I just have to make my software in such a way that it is going to accept only values from 0 to 5000. Any value, any other value which doesn't lies from 0 to 5000, your machine should not accept that value. Okay, so what I am doing in equivalence class partitioning, I am making three equivalence classes. I am making three test cases. What is my first test case? Set of all integer values. Set of all negative values. Set of all negative values. What is my second test case? 0 to 5000 values. What is my third test case? All values greater than 5000. Okay, so I have taken three test cases. First test case is set of all negative values. Any value like minus 1, minus 2, minus 10, minus 20, minus 500. Okay, we have to check our code from each and every angle. If you give this kind of value, okay, if you have made your right software, if you have done right programming, then your machine is not going to accept all these negative values. Okay, if your machine is giving some output for these values, that means you have done some mistake in your coding. Okay, next test case I have is 0 to 5000. If I give any value to machine ranges from 0 to 5000, it should give me correct output. Okay, and if it is not giving me correct output, lies in the range from value 0 to 5000, then still we say that there is a problem. The third test case we have is all values greater than 5000. Let's suppose you take 6000. You are giving 6000 value to machine. You want to find out the square root of 6000. Your machine should not give you output. Okay? Because your machine is designed to find out the square root ranges from 0 to 5000. If your machine is giving you some output, if you give value 6000, what do you understand? You understand that there is some problem present in the coding. We need to change some equivalent classes. Okay, these are three equivalent classes. Okay, we have to check our program code from each and every angle. If you are able to cross all the test cases, okay, if you are giving the right output for all the test cases, that means your program is error free. There is no mistake present in the code. It is completely error free. Okay, so this way we try to design the test cases. These test cases I designed for this example. If you have some different example, you might be having different test cases. Okay, if your program is going to completely fulfill all the test cases, that means you have no error present in your code. So it is very important that you design the right test cases. Okay, in the test cases we check each and every possible condition in our code. So it is also very important that you design your right test case. Okay, you design right test cases. Okay, so this was the equivalence class partitioning. Next, we have boundary value analysis. We have an infinite input domain. We try to limit the input domain so that in very less time we are able to identify all the errors in the program. Okay, so what boundary value analysis says? Let's suppose you have designed your software which is going to compute the square root of any value lies in the range from 0 to 5000. So we have to check that whether this software is working correctly or not. We have to design some of the test cases for that. In equivalence class partitioning, we make equivalent classes like we discussed. The first test case was set of all integer values. The third test case was all values greater than 5000. So we have equivalent classes in that case. But what happens in the boundary value analysis? What boundary value analysis say? It says that you don't need to create the equivalent classes. Okay, it says that if you have designed your software for input values ranges from 0 to 5000, you just check the boundary like this: -1, 0, 5000 and 5001. You just check your software on these boundary values. Okay, I had a range 0 to 5000. So what is the less value, the first less value than 0? -1. What is the first value after 5000? 5001. You just check your software on these boundary values. Okay, if you get any error in these boundary values, then that means you have no problem. You just want to run your software on any values from 0 to 5000. Okay, your machine should not accept -1 and 5001. Okay, so your machine should not accept these values. It should accept only these values ranges from 0 to 5000. If your machine is accepting these values -1 and 5001, that means you have some error in the coding. We have to remove that error from the coding. Okay, so this way we just try to make the test cases to determine the correctness of the coding. Okay, we try to check. We check every possible value for the software. So I hope that you are clear with black box testing. If you have any query, I have mentioned my email ID in the description box. You can contact me on that email ID. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.